So I probably should have written down a script for this video, but I'm going to ad lib like I and go improv like I usually do. This photo, I think, was probably taken when The Mandalorian premiered in 2018, and two rave reviews. And this was, I think, while during the great breakup was beginning. In 2019 or 18, when Solo premiered and it crashed and burned, it's the first Star Wars movie to lose money. Okay, I'm going to qualify that. The first Star Wars movie to lose money that we're told. Okay, TLJ probably made a little money. Tross did not. Did Rogue One? I don't know. With all the things going on behind the scenes at Rogue One, we're not sure how much money was spent. But this is about Kathleen Kennedy and Bob Iger. I think Iger realized she was incompetent. I think he started to get the feeling with all the shenanigans going on behind the scenes at Rogue One. And she did not understand her position. And in Kathleen Kennedy's place, and I'm going to say it, it is better to be forgiven than ask permission. Because if you ask permission, they may say no. And Kathy cannot afford to have somebody say no to her. Okay, she doesn't understand that word and what it means. And it was obvious from the rumors among the fans that turmoil was going on at Lucasfilm. There had been an international VTC between the branches of Lucasfilm in England and the branches of Lucasfilm in California. Bob Iger had John Lasseter and Kevin Feige listen in to that. Soon after that, Pablo Hidalgo seemingly dropped out of Twitter for a while. And Carrie Hart disappeared. Kennedy conveniently blamed the token black chick on her staff. One or two token black chicks on her staff. Okay, so we get into the fall, and Disney did not announce that Kennedy had been renewed. It just got out there in the press. There was not a big hullabaloo. And that's the first signal to me that Disney understood where the fans were with where Lucasfilm was. At the time, the fans were upset, and they didn't like Kennedy, and they wanted to keep the press to the minimum. And Kennedy, very conveniently, in my opinion, hates us back. Fine, Kathy, that's great. We can work with that, okay? But it's been public knowledge that Lucasfilm, Kennedy's minions, the Flying Monkeys, go out of their way to malign the fans. Matt Martin does. Pablo Hidalgo is the leading actor in that. His wife is a leading actor. Carrie Beck does. We are their enemy because we're the ones that pulled back. And the article that came out in Fortune, very interestingly enough, said a franchise is bigger than box office. And if it's not selling merchandise and park passes, et cetera, it's not doing well. Star Wars is not doing well, okay? And that's the truth. And that's where Kennedy is disconnected. And again, they always talk about gross box office, not net box office. And that's the big number right there. That's the real number.
There is a danger. Should I have your ship standing by?
Evacuate? In our moment of triumph? I think you overestimate their chances.
light speed and we're preparing to...
You have failed me for the last time, Admiral. Apology accepted, Captain Nida.
Fortune magazine article talks about the fandom. And now the fandom... Look, what's going on with Star Wars is akin to what's going on with Light. It's akin to what's going on with Target. We just aren't going to the parks. We're not buying the merchandise because the sequel trilogy sucks. You know, we're not going to pay $6,000 to watch, quote unquote, a bland, underwhelming villain fight a bland, underwhelming avatar of Kathleen Kennedy at the vaunted Galaxy Cruiser Hotel. Okay, just not going to do it. For 2 days, no. And these were all Kennedy's ideas. She walked into Bob Iger's office in 2015 and said, look, we've got more movies ahead of us than behind us. Why don't we put all of our efforts in the parks into the sequel trilogy? He thought about it, said, sure. Big mistake. Big. Huge. Star Wars fans who have the money to spend on things are the original trilogy fans and the prequel trilogy fans. And people that are just Star Wars fans, they like episodes 1 through 6, Clone Wars, etc., who hate with a passion the sequel trilogy. Because look, Kennedy doesn't care about Star Wars. She doesn't care. She hates the fans. The look of disdain on her face when she walks out is obvious. And we have to have a come to Jesus moment on that. And when the article mentions the fans, it is the first time a legit public bit of press acknowledged that the fans existed, that we have a point, and that we matter. And that it didn't mention the guerrilla marketing about Kenobi 2 months before attacking the fans being racist, and the idiot who thought this was a great idea put that out there. We hadn't seen a scene of the show, and you know, people were, you know, the idiots out there were making comments about Moses Ingram. Ignore it. Fucking ignore it. Okay, yet here we are. Okay, but again, Lucasfilm went and ran with that, and that hurts Star Wars. Instead of ignoring it or running with it or starting it, which they did. Okay, the fans are not racists. Bob Iger knows that. The fans are not bigots. Bob Iger knows that. The fans are not sexist. Bob Iger knows that. Fans don't like to be called names. Fans also want to be heard. It's what my analogy is, either back in the 80s when the Coca-Cola company came out with New Coke versus Old Coke, Classic Coke. New Coke sucked. It sucked. Coca-Cola apologized, admitted they made a mistake, and got rid of it. There you go. That's how you handle shit like that. Bud Light. They put a crossdresser on a can. Bud Light. I don't drink it. But guys that work 8 to 6 through the afternoon on construction sites, commercial fishermen, cowboys, you name it, people that work with their hands, police officers, don't want to go to their local bar after work, ask for a can of Bud Light, and get Dylan Mulvaney with that stupid look on his face, in their faces. That is an insult to the customer, okay? Just like in TLJ, no one wanted to see, you know, Luke Skywalker drinking green titty milk, okay? And when we complained about it, when we complained about the diminishing and attack on masculinity by Rian Johnson, by J.J. Abrams, by Kathleen Kennedy herself, we were called istophobes. And it's like, what? that look, all we ask is that Luke, Han, and Leia are respected, and they weren't, okay? They weren't. And that's what, and again, it's not a boycott. We didn't boycott, Solo. We saw the actor that was chosen by Kennedy because Steven Spielberg could not keep out of it to play Han Solo, and he was ridiculous. He's pathetic. He was awful. Call him awful, Aaron Yuck, for a reason. And again, John Kasdan diminishes Han Solo by putting that skinny, weird-looking creature, Emilia Clarke, in the forefront. It's called Solo, not Queera. Okay, what the fuck? Okay, so we had a problem. We didn't boycott. We just didn't go to the movie. Okay, and that's all Kennedy's fault. It is not Disney's fault. She made a movie. She did not watch the dailies. Bob Iger realized it. And in 2018, that's when the great breakup started. Okay, Jon Favreau puts out The Mandalorian, and he saved Star Wars' ass for a time. Kennedy saw what was going on and then was told, you're not going to do streaming shows after Andor. And she started battling with the Book of Boba Fett and probably with Kenobi. Okay. And it is beyond my comprehension why people can't just see that and say, hey, you know, we need to calm down because things are going to get better. And they are going to get better. They are going to get better. And the reason is because that article, again, doesn't beat the fans over the heads. In fact, I guarantee you, Iger was told the writer in Fortune, do not attack the fans with this. And they didn't attack the fans. In fact, we were in the forefront of why this woman right here is failing. Okay, see the short-haired chick in the background with that stupid look on her duck face? You know, Indy 5 might be a good movie, but she's going to be shoved in our faces for 2.5 hours. We're not going to get as much Indiana Jones as we want because of this duck-faced bitch. Okay, because Kennedy cannot help herself. Okay? And now that we know that Bob Iger is talking to legal, Lucasfilm legal, and that the HR departments are talking in private between HR Disney and HR Lucasfilm, that something's going on. With Jon Favreau getting the keys to the kingdom, okay, and the fact that now we've got this article out loud, it's a legit publication, asking if Kennedy's on her way out. Because Bob Iger, right here, who's far more Machiavellian than I ever thought he would be, understands that past is prologue. Shakespeare was right. Kennedy can't help herself. And this article basically talks about the fans in a good way. We have buying power. We are the audience. It's not her imaginary audience of SJWs. We are the audience, okay? Kids don't go to movies now without their parents, okay? You know, they don't care, okay? And to be honest, the SJWs are losing Generation Z if you look at it, okay? They're getting sick of this shit. But Iger knows now. Kennedy will always do this shit. She can't help herself. She's programmed herself to be this way. All right, she's an activist and she's incompetent. I guarantee you she did not look at the dailies for Indy 5. She is up in, you know, Marin County, wandering around like, you know, the Grand Poobah. And I'm sure, just like with Solo, she didn't have time to look at the dailies. And she probably liked what she saw. The problem is, Bob Iger and Bob Chapek, Alan Bergman, and Dana Walden all know the fans won't like it. And that's the problem. Because again, past is prologue. And in Kennedy's mind, she could get away with it. And she can't anymore. She was told by both JPEG and Iger to fix it. And you'd almost literally have to take the whole movie apart and refilm everything from the beginning. And then it would be a $1 billion budget. And there's no reason why a movie should cost that much. There's no reason why a movie should cost $500 million. And yet, with the reshoots alone, and we don't know how much was reshot in front of green screens and re-edited, maybe 50%, maybe more. Okay. But this was the make or break thing for Kennedy. If you don't do Indy 5 right, you're not going to get your golden parachute. And Iger knows, sadly, because I think Harrison Ford deserves a better send-off for this character, that it's not going to do well. Look, we talked about how much it actually costs, $300 million. No. With the tinkering and reshoots and all the other shit they had to do to even get it passable, it's $500 million. It's going to have to make $1.25 billion to break even, and it won't. All right. But Iger knows with Kennedy, this is what you're going to get. You're going to get a movie that needed, that never should have had her involved in the first place. Indiana Jones without Steven Spielberg and George Lucas, they are executive producers, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they have anything to do with the movie. Okay. And they don't. Spielberg walked away. Why? Questions that need to be asked. I think that should be public knowledge. And this is where we're at. We are watching the downfall of Kathy Kennedy. And I'm going to say this. Her strategy will be to attack us. When it's announced that she's leaving, we're going to get pilloried and mocked. Not in the general legit media, like Barron's and Fortune, even in Business Insider, in the Wall Street Journal. But the rags, individual writers may take shots at us. Okay, we're going to be called racists, sexists, bigots, and phobes. Okay, get ready for that. And, you know, Tony Gilroy was sounding that little bell when he white knighted her. Okay. Also, watch the black pills move the goalposts back, because they are already, I've said this before, because they need something to talk about and something to keep people upset. Stay angry. Okay. Okay. Because we're no matter what, this is 2018. This is the era of 2018 forever and ever, amen. Okay, whatever. Okay, no, it's not. So my advice for you guys is to get ready for that. All right? But this is also a good place to talk about the takeaways from this article. The fans are being respected here as people with legitimate concerns and financial power, okay? Kennedy is being called out for being an incompetent leader. And three, Iger is being asked to do something about it. All right? This is Steph, signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.